I'm Alien Centelaire, and in this video, we're going to take a look at agent customization. One way to make the experience of MeshCentral better for your users is to customize the agent so that it looks great for your organization. And it has some really important uses also. So we're going to take a look at how to customize the agent today. Now, I'm going to start with my trusty developer MeshCentral server right here. It's running on the left side, and I have the web page on the right side. And of course, it works as usual. Now, by default, when you want to install a new computer, you click on Add Agent, select the operating system you want, in my case, Windows, and I'm just going to download the default agent. And it's going to go into my download folder right there. And it's going to be Mesh Agent, the name of the device group. And then I can run it. This is not a signed agent. And this is the default dialog box for the agent. So you see it says MeshCentral agent. All the text here is internationalized in multiple languages, like German and so on. And so you can click on connection details and see if the agent's already installed and all the details of that. Okay, so this is the normal default experience for the agent installation. Now I'm going to delete this, and I am going to delete this file. And now what I'm going to do is go into my config.json for my server. And so I have a very short config.json file. The mesh agent configuration or customization is done inside the domain section. So here I have two domains, the dev test and the default. And so I'm going to go and configure the agent for the default domain. And so I'm going to grab this section of text here and bring it here. So I have this section called agent customization, and it has a few entries. So there's obviously any entry that starts with an underscore is ignored by MeshCentral. So I have to remove the underscore to make it effective. The display name and the description, those will be used to for installation into the service manager of Windows or Linux, and to on the title of the title bar for the installation dialog and so on. The company name, this is used for the installation folder where you want the agent to be installed. The service name is quite critical. It's a unique identifier for this service when you install it in the background. So if you have two default agents, they cannot be installed simultaneously. But if you have a default agent or you have two different agents configured with different service names, then they can be installed simultaneously on the same computer at the same time. And they'll be, you know, you can install and uninstall them separately. And that will work. So if you are a big organization, you are using MeshCentral, I really highly recommend you customize the service name so that you know, there's no chance that you're going to collide with another MeshCentral agent already installed on another system. Now the file name, this is the file name that you that the agent will have when you download the file. So I'm going to set that. I'm going to restart my server to make this configuration effective. And once I'm done, I am going to put this away. Actually, I'm going to bring up my download folder and say add agent and download the Windows agent. Okay, it'll take a second here, and then I can double click on it. And immediately you already see the company name is already in the, oops, run anyway. The company name is already in the agent file name. You see the company title there, and that's pretty much it. Now, obviously, these are the two strings you see here, but the other two strings, the one for the description and the service names, those will show up when you install in the service manager. Okay, so that's great, but what if I want to change the icon, or what if I want to change this text, or the color of the background of the image, or the foreground? Well, you can also do that. So I'm going to come back here. And so, by the way, the older agents, you know, 20 2021 and 2020 agents would, year 2021 and year 2020 agents, they would only support these five settings. Now, early 2022, a new agent with the blue dialog box was released, and this one supports four additional settings, and those four additional settings are image, install text, foreground, and background color. So I am going to, actually what I'm going to do is hold off on the foreground and background color. I'm just going to do image and the install text. So the install text is the main text that is shown when you in the middle of the dialog box when you run it. And the image, this is a PNG file, 200 by 200 pixels, and it needs to be in the MeshCentral data folder. So just create an image. So I have an image here of a company name. It's 200 by 200. And you save that inside the MeshCentral data folder, and you specify the name right here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open paint.net just to show you another thing, which is that the image I just showed you is has an alpha layer. So it's semi-transparent or transparent at some places and not transparent at others. And in my case, I'm going to fill this. I'm going to fill this box with black, and I just want to show you that once I put this icon over a black background, you can see that I have a semi-transparent white box around the company name here. That will become important because the agent will blend that to the background color of the agent dialog box once it runs and composes the dialog box. By the way, paint.net, great little application and all free. Okay, so I got the image, I got the install text. Let's restart the agent. Bring up my download folder. I'm going to delete this version of the agent. Download again. And of course, when you download this agent, people don't realize sometimes, but the server is actually taking the MSH file, all the settings, and merging it inside the exe of the agent. So that happens in real time when you click and download. So now when I download this and say run, it'll take a second here, and boom. Now we have the product, and actually, for some reason, the text here, let's see, install text didn't show up. So I'll debug this, but normally in your case, when you specify the install text here, then the install text should show up on in this dialog box right there. But you see the image works, and you see company product on the top. Okay, I want to try foreground, background image, color. Now, here, there's two formats that are supported. You can say RGB with commas, and this number is between 0 and 255, 255 being the max. So for example, 255, 255, 255, all that would be white, so the maximum of RGB, and 000 would be black. The other format you can use is hex. You start with a hash, and you say 00AABB. This is familiar for people who do HTML, and this means RGB, but in hexadecimal, and white would be FFFFFF, and black would be 000. So you also can use that format. And what happens is that the server will take that value, convert it correctly so that the agent will understand it. So I'm gonna take those two random values here, save the config.json, restart the server, and I am going to go back into my download folder, add the agent, save that. Okay. And now we'll run the agent again. And this time, of course, what I did is I selected some random colors. So we have some yellow, you know, background because RG is full and blue is zero. So that gives you yellow. And then I have this foreground color for the text right here. So, and the same for the connection details, you have that background, and the text is in foreground with that color. So this is kind of useful, especially if your corporate logo is kind of intended to go on a white background, you know, or that's your company kind of color, then, or you have a different company color, just put that as the full thing, and then your company logo will kind of make sense on top of that color. Anyway, that's pretty much it for agent customization. You know, you can customize the image, you can customize the text, you can customize the colors, but probably most importantly, the service name, making sure that the agent can coexist with other MeshCentral agents on the same computer. So thank you very much. Hopefully that was useful. Take care.